Hello everyone and welcome to the Captain's Video Blog. We are Saturday, April 2nd, 2016. Actually, we are Sunday morning, it's 7:30, and I really fucked up because, you know, there are two things that I do usually at night. It's eating and sleeping, if I manage to go to sleep before the sun comes up. Daybreak, sunrise, you know the thing. You know, usually it goes that way. I eat, spend some time on the computer, then I go to sleep. Today I completely fucked up in a way that I probably fucked up a couple of times this week or last week, and one time earlier in February, maybe, I don't remember exactly. So, and that's really weird because I woke up around 1 or 2 in the afternoon because of NXT TakeOver Dallas. You know, I'm still high on that Shinsuke Nakamura versus Sami Zayn match. That was so great. Like, I rewatched his entrance. I rewatched his entrance so much. And it still holds up, like people chanting Nakamura, Nakamura, and then him arriving. That's just great stuff, you know. There goes my dog. Hello, dog. So yeah. Probably wants to go outside. So let's grant his wish. Today, I can say today because well, it's the morning. Today is WrestleMania, but yeah. First, I just remembered after first sending in the upload I also watched SmackDown, and I probably didn't talk about it. Like, I probably talked about it in the description in not very good terms. It wasn't a memorable episode of SmackDown, and you could argue that very often it's not memorable, and that's probably because of the end of the brand split, you know. SmackDown was just so much better when there was still the brand split, you know, like general manager one-on-one with The Undertaker, and hola tag team matches. Like, I remember one Survivor Series that was Raw versus SmackDown, and SmackDown won because of just how often they do tag matches with people they don't necessarily like or don't usually tag with. But yeah, that was really, you know, that was SmackDown's gimmick, and I liked it, to be honest. SmackDown was my favorite brand. Like, for a time, Main Event was a place where you could have, on a very normal basis, very good wrestling without having to rely on Main Eventers, you know. SmackDown wasn't really memorable. Like, the Main Event was Dean Ambrose versus Eric Rowan, so, like, you're okay. But they are not in the same match. How? Why? This is the go-home show. I know that you focus more on Raw than on SmackDown, but still, you could focus, you know? Also, apparently, the Dallas crowd tried to emulate the English crowds from last winter's tour by doing the one fall thing. Didn't work, apparently, because I didn't hear it when I was watching, so yeah. What was I talking about? Yeah, so I slept. I woke up at 1 or or 2 p.m. Stay in my bed until 3 p.m. You know, usually because of that, I can stay awake very late at night. And this time around 1 a.m., I just felt very weak. No, my father was like, yeah, I'd like to sleep, because you know, being a firefighter, his shift was all the night, so he was hoping that he wouldn't have to go out, because he went out earlier in the evening. I was like, yeah, he was like, yeah, you're going to be awake anyway. And I was like, I certainly hope not, because I am tired. Turns out I was too tired to even go all the way to eat. Like, I was going to blame it on my short pajamas, but that's not a problem, you know. Like, I felt the heat even while dressed like this. Obviously, I was feeling cold, so I got under a cover, and I made a mistake. I laid on my back, and wouldn't you know, fell asleep. Woke up at one time around 3:30 a.m., and I was like, fuck that shit, and fell back asleep. 4:15, I was like, alright, I gotta do this, and I fell asleep once again, and woke up at around 5 a.m., and even then, I remained on my back on the couch until 6 a.m. when I decided to eat, you know, like every normal human does, right? But the big news today is, today's big news was that I finally watched a Clásico, you know, Barça versus Real Madrid. I think it is the first time. I don't remember ever watching the Clásico, which is really weird for someone who likes football like me. I usually look at the results and who scored just for the banter, you know, because I know a lot of people who are for Real Madrid. I really like Real Madrid. It's the same reason why I don't like Paris. It represents the capital and kind of the power that doesn't give a fuck about outside. Whereas Barca, despite being the rich club, it feels more like the club of the people, you know? Obviously, there's more to that. Like, I never really liked any player in Madrid besides Zidane and Raul. But these two I like them more because of their fits in their national teams, not in club. Like, when Zidane and Raul played for Real Madrid against Marseille, if I were in the stadium, I would have jeered Raul, not Zidane because he's from Marseille, but you get the gist of it. I watched the game. I didn't even watch it all the way. I remembered that Tuesday was it was game day, around 30 minutes into the match, and then I was already watching French football, which is a big mistake. You know, like, if you don't prepare yourself, you're gonna drown in all that quality, you know. Switching from, I think it was, what was the game I was watching? It was Toulouse versus Caen. Toulouse won 2-0. Very important, because Toulouse was in danger of being relegated, and with that 2-0 victory, they're allowing themselves to hope, which is a very good thing. I would hate for Toulouse to get relegated. I really like this club, and you know, being in Ligue 2 would mean that they would lose so much money and so many players, even though I would kind of like them to lose at least Wissam Ben Yedder to come at Marseille, because he's really good and he would probably, you know, gain from going to a big club. Like, I was watching the game of France versus Macedonia, there is one player who's already, you know, it's the young, the U23, yeah, and there's this player from Troyes, who is pretty good, I would say, but has no chance of making it into the national team if he doesn't go to a better club, and he's going to be one of those many players who were very good through the youth teams for the country, and then because they never went to a big team, never made it into the national team. That's kind of shitty, but yeah, that's pretty much what happens. You know, like, for a while, I even remember one time where there were, I think it's still pretty much the case, but it's not as, it's still not as bad as before. Like, there was a time where you could count out of the list of the 23 players by the coach, you could count on the fingers of one hand the players that came from the French top flight. So yeah. But yeah, then again, so I watched Barca versus Real Madrid, and Barca lost, and I was really disappointed because, like, it always has to go like this, huh? Yeah. Talking about football, Marseille plays today without Isla, who, that's normal, but that's kind of shitty because he's just back from a national, from being playing with the national team of Chile in South America. So, you know, his body is not ready yet. And Nkulu, who I don't know why he's not playing, but doesn't leave a lot of hope. Especially against Bastia, because Bastia is a pretty good team, pretty good home team. Yeah, it's gonna be tough. Like, there are usually a lot of banter between Marseille and teams from Corsica, because there's always this saying that Marseille is the capital city of Corsica, and the Corsicans really don't like it. And I myself, I'm very much torn between my allegiance to my hometown and my allegiance to the place where I have roots, you know? Usually it's more for the hometown, because Corsicans can, I mean, I won't say they can go fuck themselves, but kinda, I mean, it's football. I ain't gonna make no choice, you know? Yeah, so, that's pretty much it, I guess. I was going to talk about something else. Totally forgot about it. If I remember, I will write it in the description. So, I mean, I always do long write-ups in the descriptions. It's pretty much it could be 4 or 5 minutes of more of me talking. And I realize that it's not good, because long upload times, and sometimes, well, my phone just fucks up during the upload. It's all lost, god damn it. So, yeah. Anyway, thanks for watching. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye. Oh, well, my eyes are getting red. I thought, yeah, I'm probably not gonna find sleep before a while. Because I ate, so my body's black on the road again. But I feel that I could actually get back to sleep pretty quickly. We'll see.